Welcome to this presentation on open and distance learning. What is ODL? Where does it come from? And what are the challenges to create rich multimedia distance learning materials for context where some of your learners may have internet access, while others may not even have reliable power supply? Open distance learning is the latest generation in a fairly long history of distance learning. ODL combines aspects of all previous types of distance learning. The first generation was offered as correspondence courses. Printed material delivered through the postal system to each individual learner. Assignments were also typically posted by the learner to the tutor, and the same for the feedback on those assignments by the tutor to the learner. In countries like Australia and Canada, and later India, South Africa and China, correspondence courses were often the only option for learners who could live thousands of kilometers from the nearest school or university. Today, the correspondence model is still the dominant distance learning model in many countries. The second generation was a direct result of the widespread use of radio and later television, the broadcasting model. Lessons would be broadcasted according to a predefined schedule. In many developing countries, this model was applied for mass education, for literacy campaigns, basic health and nutrition training, and in agriculture outreach programs. The audio and video players brought us the third generation in distance learning, the multimedia model. With the broadcasting model, you still had to be near a radio or television at the time of the transmission. The multimedia model brought independence of time. Because you owned the cassettes yourself, you could now listen or watch whenever it suited you best. The computer integrated sound, video, but also educational games and simulations, in which you could interact with the learning materials. But the real innovation came from the internet. Now it was also possible to communicate with your tutor or fellow learners, in real time, through chats or audio or video conferencing, or asynchronous, through email or discussion forums. This resolved one of the major drawbacks of distance learning. Person-to-person communication was now possible. The fifth and latest generation offers ubiquitous learning, wherever, whenever you want to learn. This has become known as open distance learning. It is based on accessibility anywhere through wireless internet. This may be through a laptop, a smartphone or a tablet computer. This is also known as learning through any device. So to recap, correspondence learning brought us independence of place. The broadcasting model was accessible to anyone. It brought us open access to education. The multimedia model brought us independence of time and rich multimedia resources. E-learning and the web introduced interactivity and person-to-person communications into distance learning. And the ubiquitous model promises learning anytime, any place, through any device. ODL. What's in the name? It's open in the sense that it's open to anyone. Independent of time, so you can study whenever you want. You are not bound to a classroom, so you can study wherever you like, at your own pace, and preferably you can choose the learning media that you like best, or a combination of these. At a distance, so it's not face-to-face. What are the major drivers for open distance learning? Employability. Every professional is responsible for his or her own career these days and success on the labor market. So this means you have to work on your professional development continuously. The worlds of school and work are no longer separated. During your studies you are supposed to work, and during work you never stop learning. With busy professional and social lives, time has become a very scarce commodity. Thus learning has to become flexible whenever and wherever you have the time to do so. And all this is enabled by wireless internet and mobile devices. Next to learning resources, these also provide access to a wealth of information, often more up-to-date than in the printed press, to fellow professionals and learners all over the world, and to all sorts of services, ranging from professional associations, opportunities to manage your professional profile online, forming professional networks, sharing and managing documents and project resources, etc. Now, what are the challenges for you as an educator? especially when you are operating in an environment where your students have varied access to modern technologies. Some may actually have internet access at work or in an internet cafe. Those can benefit from ubiquitous learning materials. Others may have access to a standalone computer. Multimedia materials on a CD or flash drive may allow them freedom of time to study. Again, others may have a DVD player, requiring your multimedia materials to be distributed on DVD together with paper for the printed text. And for those learners with none of those facilities, you will still have to deliver paper-only materials. Faced with such a situation, most educators will aim for the simplest solution, which is paper-only materials for all students. Well, as long as there is no competition from other educational providers, those learners with access to some sort of technology may comply. But in the long run, the paper-only model is unsustainable in ODL. So, get ready for the future. And you know what? It can actually be fun, and your students will love you for it. This is not to say you should create a separate course for each student, of course. That is far too much work. So how does it work? Create your texts, graphics, audio fragments and video clips separately. These are called learning objects, or better even, look on the web for existing learning objects and reuse these. Then assemble these learning objects into lessons and courses for distance teaching. One version for distribution on paper, one version for distribution on DVD, maybe together with some paper materials, one version for distribution on CD or flash drive for learners with a PC, and finally, publish all your material on the web for learners that have internet access. You may ask yourself, how do I do this? What kind of equipment do I need? And what facilities does my institution need to do all this? If you are interested, you may check out some of our other free resources. Or, if you have specific questions, please feel free to contact us.